The safer the roads, the heavier my pockets. Do come again.
Could have sworn I had ought to attend to.
So this is where you've been. Come with me to the village entrance. The watchhead's waiting for you.
What say we gather some information?
Mayhap 'tis time I went looking for. That place puts my ears on it. Yet what were to befall him? I couldn't live with myself.
Well met, sir.
How might I do it, sir?
Well met, sir. How might I be of service? Do come again.
Not buying? That's just as well.
Better to be selective than wasteful.
Mayhap 'tis time I went looking for. That place puts my ears on it. Yet if aught were to befall him, I couldn't live with him.
Feels here, no one about.
My bed falls and I shan't resist.
Ah, you've returned. Good timing, too. I have questions for you. First and foremost, will you accompany me to the capital? My thanks. Are you ready to depart, or do you need some time to prepare? Good. Then let us be on our way.
No one's coming to assail us. Mayhap we've scared them all off?
A brief respite is naught to decry.
We've got goblins!
Leave it to me.
You are in need of me. Allow me.
Wait right there.
Yeah.
My magics grant you an elemental boon. The day grows darker with our every step.
Ears pricked. 'Twill be difficult to pinpoint distant foes by sight alone.
Just yonder looks to be a good spot for harvesting ingredients.
I say, we collect as much as we...
The Arisen is the lawful ruler of Vermund. So it has always been. To claim the title is to claim the throne. Yet, not all claims are true. Our kingdom sees many pretenders, and they are not dealt with lightly. Best hope you're not one of them. Regardless, you would do well not to invite my mistrust on our journey.
I grant you lightning's fangs! I shan't let them harm you. Well, of course, Arisen.
Let's see, I've some catching up today.
Arisen, you are full of surprises. I look forward to informing my own master of that strategy.
Truly?
Hold here a moment. I shall bid them open the gate.
Who's that you've brought with you, Watchhead, sir?
An Arisen, by all appearances.
An Arisen? Another pretender, you mean? I see the Sovereign's ascension has done little to stop such charlatans from plying their trade.
'Tis uncertain. This one commands the loyalty of the pawns.
What? Impossible. You know as well as I do that there can be but one Arisen, and he's up in the palace.
I'm well aware of how preposterous the idea is, thank you. However, as I do not believe it my place to rule on such a matter, I would make my report to the capital. If the claim is false, we will be rewarded handsomely for our trouble. If the claim is true, however, who can say? All's been arranged. Come, let us pass through the gate.
I don't know about you, Master, but I'm worn out. Mightn't we have a rest before pressing on?
An ox cart was meant to meet us, yet tis nowhere in sight. Aught may have befallen it. Best we press on.
My curative magics are at your disposal. Wait a moment.
Why bother carrying a lantern, if not to use it when light is needed?
That looks promising. Any ideas as to how we might reach it? This seems a decent spot for a campsite.
The hour may be growing late, but I'm in no need of a rest just yet.
On your side. That was superb, Arita. All right.
More marks of the dragon's fury. Its rampage must have weakened the earth.
That was well fought. There's no one standing who might say otherwise.
No doubt this triumph will spur us into the next.
Let my magic imbue your weapon with the fury of the elements.
I dare say the cart shan't be traversing this. Onward! It might await us on the road ahead.
Has been torched! Quick! Douse the flames! It was excellent! I could have done no better!
Let's see more where that came from.
Well said. We have found a material.
I have a knack for gathering items, and am ever on the hunt for new finds. I'll gladly try out any useful mechanisms I espy. Delighted to meet you, especially if we share a sweet tooth. Well, never for a moment did I doubt you'd grow stronger someday. Having said that, 'tis quite a relief.
There's no discipline that steadfast devotion cannot teach.
Ready to tackle today's adventures, Arisen? I'm full of vim myself. Where to next, Arisen? I'm not sure I've any idea. There are useful ingredients to be gathered here, I'll wager.
Shall we see if there's aught to be found while we're here?
There's aught to be found there.
Can you not see it?
We ought to take a closer look.
make them rue their own patience.
Battle cannot be avoided. It is fight or die.
Did anyone else see that? Orc catches the light.
We ought to take a closer look. Look, Master! Goblins! You have no means of exploiting our enemy's weakness! Douse the flames! The fort is too late!
You are in need of peace. Allow me.
Wait over there! How's water with you? Let my magic imbue your weapon with the fury of the elements.
The ingredients are plentiful hereabouts.
No harm in picking a few.
I could look upon this sky for all eternity, if 'twasn't for the crick in my neck.
Keep gazing upward and you're like to stumble ere long. We have found a material.
Different combinations of materials result in different creations.
sense letting the enemy gain the upper hand. Early Griffin gets the worm.
Strike with lightning on your side.
Am I the first to notice we've all got different vocations?
Our respective abilities are unique as well.
We must each of us hone our skills. A jack of all trades is a master of none. I'm all for swapping stories, but perhaps another night? I can scarce keep my eyes open.
Agreed. We ought to give ourselves a chance to recover ere we continue on our journey.
How might I aid you, sir?
Sir, how can I be of assistance?
This place makes my hair stand on end. Should trouble occur, it's my charge to set it right. The quiet day is a welcome one.
I've a knack for gathering items and am ever on the hunt for new finds. I'll gladly try out any useful mechanisms I espy.
Our master's flights of fancy may lead us down roads unforeseen, but there's an indubitable joy in all the chaos.
How might I serve you, Arisen? Where ought we to go now? Burning the midnight oil, I see. Good evening, Arisen. Good morrow, everyone.
Off we go, then.
Oh, I don't know about you, but I am full of vim and vigor.
I see you recognize my worth, Arisen. I suppose I should consider myself honored to serve.
Staring, Arisen. Has aught yonder caught your eye?
What's this? We're trapped!
Cyclops! To think we'd encounter one here, of all places.
Cyclops, pray, be on your guard.
Let my magic grant you with elements between us.
Seem I misjudged you. I had taken you for another false Arisen. Goodness knows we see a lot of them. Yet the valor you showed in coming to our aid has dispelled such thoughts. Here, take this as a mark of my trust. Give it to one of the sentinels stationed at the gates to the capital, and you'll be granted an audience with Captain Brandt. You're free to make your own way to the capital now. I see no need to keep you under constant watch, and I'm sure you'll breathe a little easier as well, aye? Of course, if you'd rather continue to accompany us, you are still welcome to join us on the oxcart. Tis your decision.
Useful ingredients to be gathered here, I'll wager.
Shall we see if there's aught to be found?
Ah, here's the cart now. Do you intend to join us? Very well. Board the ox cart and we'll be off.
That ladder looks promising, but we'll have to drop it down from above.
This will seem of little consequence, but different masters favour different pawns. One whom I served preferred to have beastruns for allies.
Fascinating. Is your pack slowing you down, Master? Pray, bear in mind that you can only carry so much by yourself.
Goblins! What rotten luck! We've need of your aid again, sir.
Goblins approach!
Fall back, and I will heal you with my magic.
Wait right there. I cannot want your prowess.
Perhaps you might join the fight yourself!
Well, sir.
Impeccable!
Seems we drove them off. You've my thanks for aiding us. Vernworth isn't far from here. Will you join us the rest of the way? All right. Into the ox cart, then.
If you are in need of aid,
Say the word.
I was informed of your coming would be arisen.
Captain Brand, this individual summoned a pawn through a rift stone. Several witnesses can attest to it. Though I admit I had my doubts at first, it would seem this is no mere deceiver.
This one's not a bad sort. Saved our hides on the way here.
As decreed by the great will of our world, there can only be one arisen. That arisen now resides within the palace. Indeed, he is our sovereign and the rightful ruler of Vermond. It follows, therefore, that this ruffian before us is naught but a pretender. You must submit to questioning. If you value your life, you will not attempt to flee. I shall conduct the interrogation myself. Stand watch outside. I beg your forgiveness for my insolence, Your Majesty. If the Queen Regent had learned of your existence, I fear your life would have been in peril. I had no choice but to treat you as a pretender, lest my actions draw suspicion from watchful eyes. Then you have truly lost your memory? In that case, mayhap I ought to explain the situation before we proceed. You, and no other, are the sovereign, the only legitimate ruler of this kingdom. Some days passed, you confronted the dragon in the village of Melv, whereupon you became arisen. The people rejoiced, for our true liege had finally appeared, and in Vermond's long years of council rule. Yet, not all celebrated your coming. Your arrival would have robbed the Queen Regent Deesa of everything. During the time of the previous council, she acted as a queen in her own right, ruling the palace as she saw fit. And just after the council's passing, when 'twas all but certain that her son would take his father's place, word reached the castle that the arisen had been found. To Deesa, Your Majesty's very existence is naught but an obstacle to her own family's continued prosperity. The assassination of the arisen is an impossible feat for mortal hands. Thus, Deesa chose to abduct Your Majesty while you recovered from your wounds, in order to rob you of your memory with a fell curse and sell you to Batal as a slave. Following that, she prepared a replacement to serve as the sovereign in your stead, a mere puppet. However, with Your Majesty returned, I have no intention of twiddling my thumbs as Deesa plays her games. I shall devise some plans to further our cause. Pray, visit me a night in the tavern that we might discuss them. This one's cleared of all suspicion, and has my permission to remain in the capital. You are to trouble the good sir no further. Are we clear?